Ethan Carter, I didn't know. But he knew who I was. When the police won't help you and the priests don't believe you, you call on Paul Prospero. You call on me. If you're a kid like Ethan, you're right. Plenty do. Ethan's letter started out just like any other fan mail. But soon there were mentions of things no little boy should know about. There are places that exist that very few people can see. Ethan could have drawn a map. I hadn't entered Red Creek Valley yet, but already I could feel its darkness reaching out for me. Finding Ethan Carter wasn't going to be as easy as knocking on his door. I was too late for that. To find Ethan, I had to figure out what this place was trying to hide from me.
Ethan, I told you, you can't be here.
But, Gramp, I wrote something for you.
That's real nice. Thank you. Just leave it. I'll read it later.
Red Creek Valley seemed like a quiet, ordinary place. I've learned two things in my life. No place is truly quiet, and nowhere is really ordinary. Ethan warned me about that. Warned me not to be fooled by what I saw here. He didn't need to worry. I'd worked dozens of cases, hundreds. This would be my last one.
Thank you.
listen to me. We can destroy it. I know how.
You can't destroy it, Ethan. You can't destroy time. And that's what he is. He is forever.
Travis, tell me where Ethan is.
Listen to me. We can destroy it. I know how.
You can't destroy it, Ethan. You can't destroy time. And that's what he is. He is forever.
Gale, honey, I wish there was another way. Travis, tell me where Ethan is, now.
I'm giving the sleeper what he wants, what all of us want. Look, old man, you need to go home.
God damn it. Go! Get out of here! Travis, close your eyes. I'm sick too. I can feel the sleeper in my head.
Then fight it! I have to destroy the room!
Travis, I'm sorry. Ethan.
Oh no!
I can't let you do that.
Whatever had turned Ethan's family against him, the grandfather was trying to resist. Age helps against those things that feed on hate. Not because of wisdom or experience. Because the old are tired. Their hate is less useful.
out of my room, Travis!
Stories, stories. Always with the stories.
Get out!
I read the Fangs one. I liked, the Beast. At least he gets to leave this goddamn place.
Trains have been through here for a long time. That was part of a pattern. Large pieces of this country were thrown away, doomed to become, and then remain, the worst versions of themselves. Beneath all that rot, dark things grow.
Thank you. Why are you standing there? You spying?
No.
No, huh? What the hell's wrong with you exactly?
Nothing.
You need to stop leaving your stupid stories around. They're freaking everyone out.
Getting worse. They keep talking about this thing, this sleeper.
I know.
You have to help us. It's the only way. It wants Ethan.
Many reasons. They want to ask me questions about the future. But I can see the future. So it is the past that interests me. If you want to find my house, you must answer the questions I ask of you. Do you love for yourself or for others? When you close your eyes, whose voice do you hear? There is vanity and charity. Does death bring peace or suffering? Do you admire thieves for their bravery or their greed? Does sin come from the heart or the mind? Ethan, the point of life is not to rock the boat. Just try to get along. Stop living in your head. Do something real. That's what people respond to. Reality.
Our boy. Chad is putting our boy in that crypt.
And bricking him up. Giving him to the sleeper. Forever.
He's harmless. You know this is wrong.
Chad, finish those bricks before he wakes up.
Ah, my leg!
Chad, let me see it.
Get the hell away from me. This is Dale's fault. He should have been helping.
Dale's weak. He always has been.
You're right. He is weak.
Chad! Get off of him! He's your brother! Get off of him!
Oh my God.
The hell's going on? Where's Ethan?
The one who sleeps must not sleep. Your Uncle Chad is dead. Rose. Ethan.
That's not right. Ethan's our boy.
Dad, I need to get into the mine.
What? Mine? My key. I don't have it.
I guess I'll use the tunnel near the gate. Just keep Mom away from me, all right? She's sick. You're all sick.
The sleeper must not sleep. Ethan disturbed something. Whatever it was, it got out into the air and into the minds of his family. What do the dead have to say? You'd be surprised by how little they know. The dead can't explain what it means to be dead. They walk down stairs that disappear beneath their feet, headed for some bright blade of memory they'll never reach.
trouble, Ren. Why wouldn't he? Why would he be here? Shit. That was probably a raccoon.
No. No, I don't think it was.
He's just a kid. He didn't disturb anything. He just found a room in an old house. That's it!
Oh, boy, is the price. I'm going up there. The sleeper must not sleep. He can't get away. It's the sleeper's time to awake.
Missy, listen to yourself.
No. I see clearly. The sleeper breathes inside me.
You're sick. We all are.
Dale, what are you doing?
Where's Mom? I thought I heard her voice.
She's, still looking for you. You need to leave. Go through there.
Through that water? It kind of looks like it's boiling.
No, it's just a simple chemical reaction. It's not actually boiling.
Mom! Where are you?
I'll deal with your brother. Just go, now.
He didn't kill his wife. She was no longer who she once was. Neither was he. Something was using all this pain and death. Something was becoming stronger.
Thank you.
Ethan. I told you to stay out. God damn it. Look, it's dangerous in here. I'll read your story later. Okay? And, please don't tell your mother I'm in here. All right? Okay, now, you go. Get back home.
Feel two kinds of darkness here in Red Creek Valley. The first you walked into and, with any luck, walked out of. But the other darkness was deeper, stickier, unknowable, and it wanted me to leave.
Thank you.
Where's my mother? Why are you standing in the sleeper's way?
She had an accident. Travis, put down the axe.
An accident.
I didn't want her to get hurt. We're all so sick, you know? Since Ethan found that room.
Where's Ethan, goddammit? Talk to me!
Okay, okay! He wants to burn Vandergriff's room. Look, Travis, just leave me alone! Oh, God. Oh, God!
The sleeper chooses vessels. You know that? To enact his wishes, he chose Mom. He chose me.
Son, I don't want to hurt you.
You think scissors are gonna save you?
Yes.
It didn't have to be this way. You could have helped the sleeper, helped us. But Mom's right. You're a coward, and you'll be meeting Ethan again soon. Disturbed it, not me.
Travis, we can get rid of it. I know exactly what we're up against. Don't listen to what's in your head.
This sleeper was feeding on them. Their hate, their distrust. Ethan's father figured suicide wouldn't feed it, but it did. I could feel it sitting somewhere out there. Fat as a bullfrog, digesting. was close. I could feel him. A pinprick of light in the darkness. He would know me. He would know why I'd come.
Destroy the room!
Corvus, I'm sorry. Ethan. Ethan, I fought it off. It's okay.
Grandpa, get away from me!
Your grandmother Gail is protecting me from it. Ethan, I can help you.
I found Vandergrift's diary. He said for the sleeper to wake up, someone has to suffer. Look! When I found that room, I didn't wake him up. He's trying to wake up now. Vandergrift kept his victims alive. He made them suffer. That's what the sleeper wants.
We need to get in that room.
I can squeeze through.
It has to be this way. The sleeper must not wake. Burning the room won't matter, Ethan. The sleeper's inside us now.
Grandpa! Get back!
We all have to die. Even you. Even me.
Wake up. Well, kid, you stopped it. It was horrible, but you stopped it.
Paul Prospero? Are you really here?
I'm sorry, Ethan. I was late. Too late.
You're right. You were too late.
Here. Again. I knew this story. And it was Ethan's as much as it was mine. And it wasn't finished. Not yet.
Christ, Ethan, you're in here again? You missed dinner. Mom and Dad are pissed. They've been looking all over the place.
Get out of here, Travis. Leave me alone.
Hey, Ma! He's in here! Honey, be careful with that lamp.
Dale, what the hell's wrong with your kid? Painting on walls, writing his stories. I mean, what the fuck?
Ethan! For God's sake, you missed dinner!
I'm sorry. I've been working on a story all day. How long have I been out here?
The Adventures of Paul Prospero, Supernatural Detective. Where do you get this stuff?
Pop, would you get Travis out of here, please?
He draws pictures on walls. What the hell is that?
Chad, shut up.
You got yourself a faggot for a son, Dale.
Travis, let's go. Come on.
Faggot! Ethan, you're a fucking faggot!
Travis, stop it!
Oh, shit!
Shit!
Everyone, go! Get out!
Get out! The smoke, it's toxic!
Jesus.
Oh, God!
What do we do?
What do we do?
I wrote about you, but I don't know if I created you.
You made me real.
I can't go yet. I have to finish my story about you. I wrote stories about everyone.
I know you did, but my story's done, and it's a fine story.
I can let go?
You can let go.
What happens then?
Another story, kid. What else?